Okay, so our final video. So here is one that this is the iliopsoas muscle, which pulls you into, oops, sorry about pulls you into hip flexion. Okay, but this just says what is the rotary and the stabilizing or LFL component here. And so this is just a straight resolution of vectors. So I like to complete my rectangle. And so I have, if this is 55 degrees, this angle is 35, and this is 55. So basically, the sine of 55 degrees or so is equal to the leg opposite, FR, over F. Call this iliopsoas muscle F, and the cosine of 55 degrees will give you FL over F, and then you solve for F. Okay, pretty straightforward. Going on to our foot, the ankle joint again. So we have, again, our ankle joint is our center of rotation or our fulcrum. We have a torque that's pulling you into plantar flexion up on your toes, and a torque that's pulling you into dorsiflexion. And so the plantar flexor torque is MF, force of the gastroxoleus, times D, which is the perpendicular distance. So that's the moment arm. And that is equal to the torque that's pulling you into dorsiflexion, which is your ground reaction force, which is acting up. And that is times the perpendicular distance from that line of force to the axis of rotation, or 2D. Okay,